The five Labour councillors signed the petition while on their way into the town hall for an evening meeting 5 weeks ago. And petition organiser Keith Thompson says the wording on the form was quite clear. Besides supporting political status for the May's prisoners, the last sentence called on Hackney Council to put up a monument to the 10 dead IRA hunger strikers in the town hall forecourt. Although none of them has denied signing the petition, some of the councillors insist that when they did so, there was no mention of the monument.
I think they're rather embarrassed that something has come to light which they thought maybe never would see the light of day. That is that they support the H Block prisoners and that they've agreed to do something practical as a way of showing that. I think they rather thought that by signing the petition, nothing really would happen. But now it has happened, they've all taken a step backwards.
Among the other 150 signatures is that of Ernie Roberts, Labour MP for Stoke Newington. Today, Mr Roberts said he was withdrawing his name because he too was not aware of the monument plan when he signed. The row has already made headlines in the local paper, which quotes one councillor as saying she's prepared for legal action. Meanwhile, the petition organisers, delighted with the extra publicity, have produced a sketch of the proposed monument, which she unwittingly supported. All five Labour councillors were unavailable for interview today, but I was able to speak to two of them on the telephone. Councillor Patrick Kodikara admits that he did not read the form all the way through. It was presented to him by an acquaintance and he signed it in good faith. But Councillor Ron Heisler insists that he did read the entire form and that it made no mention of the monument. Had it done so, he would not have signed it. The monument idea, he said, was absolutely absurd because, and I quote, Hackney Council hasn't got enough money for the living, let alone the dead. Stephen Chambers in Hackney for Thames News.